You know, I had the honor. Anybody from the Shawnee area, you all live around here now, but anybody originally from Shawnee or know the Shawnee area? I represented Shawnee in the state legislature. It was a fascinating and enjoyable job, but one of the things that I learned as a legislator is for my ideas to make a difference, I had to know how to count. I had to count votes. Now, I'm not saying there are some legislators who don't know how to count. I mean, some people might think that. You have to count 63 votes in the Kansas House, 21 votes in the Senate, get a governor's signature, or you're just whistling in the wind, because that's what it takes to pass a bill and to make a difference with it. But one of the first things I learned when I had the honor of serving as Attorney General is I no longer need to count. I decide. It's one of the most powerful positions in American government today. Even the presidency, which of course is the most powerful position, but implements law that is passed by Congress. What a attorney general and a district attorney is supposed to do, and what they do every day, is decide whether they're going to enforce law by filing charges, or sometimes even decide to ignore evidence of criminality and not file charges. And then once the charges are filed, you make a decision on the dispensation of the case, whether you're going to proceed to trial or, in many cases, end up in a plea bargain. And if you were to study how the role is covered by the media and how the public is informed about what a district attorney and an attorney general does, you will find that most people are completely lacking in knowledge of some of the substantive and important decisions that have been made by people who hold that office. It is an incredibly frightening power. And what I want to mention to you, and then I want to talk to you about some of the changes that I'm bringing and what I believe is important to continue to bring to Johnson County as your district attorney. But one of the things I want to mention to you is it's vitally important that the person that you place in that office know who they are. You know, most decisions in life, let's see, most decisions in your personal lives come down to, once you get a lot of input and you think about it and you might pray about it and you consider it, they come down to those quiet moments when you decide what is right and what is wrong. And then you decide to stand up for what is right. That's what you need in that office more than anything else, is a person who, when they are away from you, will decide to do what is right, regardless of what personal cost that might be visited upon them. And all too often in our society today, I believe the modern definition of leadership is self-preservation. It's about perpetuating one's own power or holding on to a title or winning an election. And that's not the leadership that we need. Leadership truly is about doing what's right and then having faith that by doing what is right, that you essentially maintain the goodness of your soul, quite frankly. So that's what's important in leadership.